Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show you how to install our custom designed, the very best upscaler right now, the super installation on RunPod on a very cheap GPU, and I will explain you the likely errors that you are going to encounter so you will not have any issues while you are installing our application on RunPod. You see currently this is 3090 GPU and only 26 cents per hour. It is super cheap and it is working amazing. You see this is 2 megapixels upscale and I can upscale up to 5, 6, 8 megapixels on this GPU, maybe even more. So let's begin. Okay guys, in this video I am going to show you how to install SUPIR on RunPod quickly because some people are having problems. Download zip file, then let's go to our RunPod, log in your RunPod, click pods, deploy, GPU pod. I am going to deploy onto community cloud, select extreme speed here. Now you can pick any GPU that has over 24 GB. For this tutorial, I will show RTX 3090, but you can also get a 6000 GPU. So it is up to you, let's get 3090. You can also click change template and type PyTorch to get it like this. Edit port, make the volume disk like at least 8 GB like this, set override and deploy on demand. Now go to my ports. Here there is very important thing that you have to be careful of. Make sure that your port has minimum 31 GB. In some cases it is giving you 20 GB RAM memory, and if you get such RAM memory it will not work. Make sure that your port has over 31 GB RAM memory, otherwise it may not work accurately. So this port has 31 GB, therefore it should work very well. After connect button appeared, click connect. Connect to Jupyter Lab. Okay, it's not ready yet. So you need to wait until it becomes ready. Let's refresh. Okay, not ready yet. Let's look at the logs. Okay. Yeah, it became ready. So it may take a while. This RAM is extremely important. Also, if you want more speed, you should get a 6000 GPU. I will show a 6000 on massive compute because it will be better for you to use on massive compute. It is much cheaper. So let's upload all the extracted files into there. Then open the RunPod instructions. By the way, instructions are same for every GPU, it doesn't matter. Okay, open a terminal, copy paste this command. This is for installation. Now wait and look at the messages carefully to see whether there are any errors or not. You see this pod is very slow. You see the download speed. Therefore I will not wait and I will get a new pod. And also there were some yellow icon here. So if your pod is slow like this, do not wait. Just delete it and get a new pod. So I will get a new pod because there are so many pods on the RunPod which are not good to use. Unfortunately, I will also this time filter for NVMe SSD disk. So it should be better. Okay, everything is set. Let's set the volume disk one more time. Deploy on command. Let's go to my ports. Okay, this one has 23 GB, so it will not work. So let's delete this one too. Unfortunately, this is something that you have to try. Let's try again. So let's make the system gigabyte per GPU like 48 GB. Yes. And let's go 3090. Okay, edit template. Let's make this 80. And deploy on demand my pods. Okay, this time I have amazing pod. The speed not looking good for the hard drive, but it has 77 GB RAM. Let's see what we will get. Okay, new GPU pod started. Let's connect to Jupyter Lab and see the speed of this one. The previous one was very bad. I'm not going to delete these parts of the video because these are the most common errors that you encounter. And then think it doesn't work because of the RunPod system. I'm going to introduce you massive compute, which is much better. Hopefully I will make a tutorial for that. Okay, it is starting. Let's see, this one looks faster than the previous one. Yeah, the speed of this pod is many times better, many times better. So it was a good choice to delete the previous one and load this one. This one has over 100 megabytes per second. Previous one were struggling with 2 megabytes per second. You see, getting a fast pod is super important. It is downloading models with 90 megabytes per second. If you can find a faster pod, your installation will be faster. Alright, everything installed. You see, all the models are downloaded. Also, verify that you don't have major error. This is not important. We fix that. And you see, all the messages are here. So we are ready. Then return back to instructions and copy this command. Open a new terminal, paste it, and it will ask you few options to start the Super Gradio. Okay, since this is a 24 gigabyte GPU, I am going to start as FP8. I am going to use tiling. Tiling is really slowing down the speed, but it allows you to generate much higher resolution. So I am going to start with using tiled one. I am going to keep the GPU always in the VRAM memory, so it will be faster. So I will say keep models always in GPU, and I will start with light dim, and that's it. If you get 48 gigabyte GPU, you can make this non-tiled and you can get double speed. Okay, it started on the local URL, then it should start on the Gradio. Yes, we have. And click the Gradio. Hopefully I will add new features and make a much better, much bigger tutorial soon. So let's upload an image from our downloads. For example, let's see. Okay, let's upscale this. This is a very small image, only 300 pixels, and the final pixel will be 2 megapixel. So apply lava. By default we are using Juggernaut XL, and when you use that you have to reduce the text CFG if you don't want the model to age it or change it too much. So I will set this as like 6, and that's it, and process single. Then it is going to load the first lava, then it will load the model. On the RunPod, sometimes loading may take too much time because of the pod itself. Let's see if this one will be fast or not. I think loading the lava is pretty fast. You can see here. So it should start getting the caption with the lava. Yes, moving the lava to GPU. The lava moved to GPU. And it is now processing with the lava. The first time run will be always slower. Lava process it, and it is going to load the super into the VRAM. Let's see. Initially it will load everything on to memory, then it will move them to the GPU memory. So having high RAM pod is extremely useful and important. Okay, loading model from the disk right now. Let's refresh. Okay, you see the RAM is increasing, so it is reading the model from the hard drive into the RAM. The first model loading is taking huge time. This happens on some GPUs, but you have to wait it for the first time. Then we will not wait it anymore once it is loaded, so it is fine. Okay, the first image generation took forever, 460 seconds, because model loading take ages. So let's try again. This time I will not apply lava because we got the prompt here. So let's process single image. This time it will not load the model again because we keep the model on the VRAM already, and it is only using 42%. Therefore we can even upscale into higher resolution, like 4 megapixels, 5 megapixels. And you see it started already. It is going to do 50 steps. Second upscale took only 85 seconds, and if we were not using tiled, it will take like 40 seconds, maybe lesser. So this is it. Hopefully see you in the bigger and next tutorials later.